Hello everybody, good afternoon. Today as I'm going to present on motivating the high technology worker. Okay, so I'll discuss on various factors, motivation factors, and who is high technology worker, what are the challenges like the current industry we are facing, right, and managers are facing to retain the high technology workers, and what are the characteristics of high technology workers. And then I'll present the motivation factors which will allow us to at least retain those high technology workers. And then there's two strategies I'll discuss.
Okay, next slide.
In this slide, I'll try to discuss like who is high technology worker. A high technology worker is one who has a lot of knowledge and he has a set of expertise with him. And also he is a highly qualified, and then he has brings a lot of comprehensive thinking with him, and he is actually an important part of enterprise nowadays, because very competitive and climate business, lot of competitive enterprises and all, there is a lot of competition, so this is very important for part of the enterprise. As we management group, Peter Drucker said, who is like a knowledge worker is a who masters and apply the symbols and concept of the knowledge or information. Okay, and the people also who actually imply those symbols and concept, who has actually gathered the knowledge. And then various challenges, we'll say, like actually when manager goes, he realizing nowadays it's understanding knowledge or a technical worker is different than other staff, like admin staff or sales staff, because he has his own way of thinking and reaction towards some other environmental, or reaction towards whatever happens around him. So these are all different challenges, I can say. And there is challenges like downsizing, reduced employee loyalty, and the absence of job security. There is a lot of job insecurity is there. That's why these are all challenges which are we are currently facing. So having discussed this, like now I would like to present like what are the different characteristics high technology workers bring. So I can say this listed set of characteristics. I can say is high level of knowledge. He has a lot of knowledge with him, and technology workers, they are always self-motivating, learn new things, update their skill sets, that kind of, like they want autonomy to learn the things, self-demanding autonomy, because they want to keep updated their skills and all these things. So one another characteristic, self-demanding autonomy, and no to business loyalty, as they have a lot of demand and all these things, they are very low to business loyalty as such. So
easily job off.
Yeah, they can jump into other, because there are a lot of demand for high tech workers. That's also impact the enterprise. And the result of the work is not easy to monitor. It's not like manufacturing a worker, we can evaluate easily like how many product are manufactured, what are the quality and all those things. But here it's all of mind game, thinking, capacity, innovation and all those things. So it's not easy to monitor the high tech technology workers. So you monitor this also like perform, evaluate them. That's also difficult because there is no end result as such. So paid, they are already usually high tech technology workers are paid high usually compared to other staff in the organization, and demand to participate in the management, because there is management requires constant interaction with the high technology workers to take their decisions and evaluate their decisions. So there is a lot of demand them to involve in the management issues. Now in the, what are the motivating factors, like what are the factors that motivate the high technology workers? These are list of individual growth. They should be given a chance to grow themselves in respect to their enterprise or organization, so they can also feel like I'm also growing in this, like I'll be going in this direction. They should be very clear on their scope and visibility towards next growth. and the remuneration and the and their work and reward. As Anil has already discussed all of the rewards and remuneration, how it impacts the motivation and all those things. This is one of the aspects. And there's job autonomy. Job autonomy, like they are very technical, they want the freedom to do their experimentation, that time and all those things, because they can't judge on their, it's not like timely bound, sometimes requires a lot of time, you know, to come up with their own ideas, innovation and all those things. So they need autonomy. They can't like every time come and monitor them, what's the result, what's the, you can't go and keep bugging him. That actually demotivates them. And the challenging work, they always look for a challenging work because they like that. That's how they keep themselves, you know, satisfied. They can satisfy. There is a challenging work. Once they do it and correlate with that what they have done, they can, they'll get a sense of, you know, satisfaction. Like, oh, yeah, I've done this instead of all these challenges. Another thing is business achievements. Like, what are the business they are going to achieve out of their work and all those things. Last one is future of the company. That's also important because they always correlate with their growth and the company's growth. So what is the future of the company, what they are working on? So with this in mind, like what if motivation factors and all, like we can have different strategies. Companies nowadays are adopting different strategies as such. Like they will give more material incentives, like pay structure, salary wise, pay high salaries, and competitive salary with respect to the current market. And then employee stock ownership, as we discussed, ESOP. And because ESOP, by ESOP we are making sure that they are loyal to the company, for retain them for a certain period of time. Because as company grows, that their ESOP amount also depends. So they can correlate their growth as well.
In effect, he becomes a part owner of the company.
Yeah, he is also a part owner of the company. And so that he can have that, you know, a responsibility as well, and for the motivation factors. And to provide a broader space of personal development. Yeah. So he can give a personal development also. That's what they also like, individual growth. That is what one of the factor. So if they provide a broader space, so like his own personal development with some training, that, this, everything, and then keep and update his skills and all the things, then it will be good. Create a good collective environment. Like now we'll just know there is a lot of politics in that, politics here, and transparency, that, this. So the work environment where he's working. So we should make sure that it's a collective effort, team effort, you know, a good environment, work environment. So we have to provide those things too. So this is one more strategy. As in our last previous slide, we have discussed the internal and external pay mechanism, or like this one. In this, we have internal appraisal, evaluation process should be good, and all those things. And external, like what the current market, like what is that demanding, and how the same level of technology worker, what he is getting outside. All these are external factors. And the career planning to help employees. This is one of the good thing. Like, we should have a career planning for them also. Like you can provide them, okay, this promotion, you'll promote it to this. We have a proper career path to have them in this company. So we can have a counseling kind of thing, like we can help them to achieve their individual career planning also. So they'll be happy, because it's not only the intensive which actually technology persons are looking for, it's also the other factors which are very important than incentives.
They are going to do
the
fast
track. Yeah.
Yeah. So, that
would flexible timings. Like that, it comes in create a collective environment.
Fine.
So the last, like, I would like to conclude that today's economy is very competitive, and there is a constant fluctuation, and business needs are increasing, and all those things. The skilled technical workers are, they are very competitive, so they can hop from one country to another. So in order to keep your high-tech employees motivated, we need to have incentives, rewards, whatever we discuss, factors, so challenges, transparent appraisal systems, and outside enterprise competition, or like external internal things. And also like then when you take all these things together and then we'll come up with such good strategies to motivate the employees, then definitely, you know, it will be a value. They are also a value to other team members also. So this, like, thank you.